Hi, Nikolai from Bunker Samples here. It is often said that when you limit your options, you become more creative. So I decided to put that to the test by writing a short piece of music using only the sounds in Bunker Samples' new tri-pack. Now, the tri-pack only costs $1, so you only get a few select sounds, and they're designed to give you an idea of how each instrument in the catalog sounds and functions, so you can see if the full version is something that's worth it to you. But does it contain enough to use only these sounds for a piece of music? Let's find out. This is what I came up with. So that's a piece in question, and as you can hear, it's built around this very simple idea of just some neighboring tones, and then the last two chords in the sequence, it goes from the flat 7 to the major 5, and that repeats basically 3 times. It gets developed a little bit. We'll talk about that. I use the harmonium to open the piece, and then I use one of the built-in effects on the interface to add that distortion as it builds into the quiet section, kind of. So if we open here, you'll see that I've mapped the drive to CC3, and as we play through, to accompany that, I'm using a bunch of Bunker Strings Volume 1 and 2 together. So if we listen to the strings only, the only shorts you get in the tri-pack are the viola pads from Volume 2, but you do get the full functionality. These are guitar plectrum shorts, so they're like a pizzicato, but they have a lot more bite. And you also get these non-tonal strums. So it sounds like this. Halfway through the introduction, I start introducing some percussion to add a bit of dry into the build. And for this, I'm using Bunker Perk. You get 12 selected hits. And the big thing to know about Bunker Perk is that you can edit each sound individually, place it in a room, tune it up and down, and make it sound completely different. So that's why you'll see the controls move about as I play through this section here. I'm also using some of the reverses. These are the exact same sounds, just played backwards and mapped in their own bespoke engine. So together it sounds like this. I'm also using a pit spin from Offworld Volume 1 towards the end of that big build. After the introduction comes a quiet section where I'm using the sustained concertino super soft from Intimate Viola to play the theme. And under that, I'm tucking in the bow pulses very, very quietly just to add a bit of body to the sound. Sounds like this. Very intimate and quiet, but that's the whole point of this library. Let's listen to Bunker's strings in this section. A bit into the phrase, I'm also supporting the melody in the middle section very quietly with Offworld Volume 2, and then it goes into octaves towards the end, so that you are ready for the sort of everybody going for it on the last run through of the theme. So let's listen to just the Offworld sounds. And as you can hear, I'm using the gate sequencer in Offworld Volume 1 without any bends on it to add a little bit of rhythmic interest. I'm also using a patch from the harmonium up here to strengthen that bass line, and that is using the volume LFO to do kind of the same thing. And finally, I have also created a sort of bass pads. So Offworld together with the bass in the harmonium, and you get this. To add a bit more rhythmic drive towards the end, together with the percussion, I'm also using the plectrum pits in the violas in Bunker String Volume 2 and the non-tonal strum, but this time I'm sending it to a delay. Nothing special, it's just a replica from Native Instruments, but I love that delay, and it sounds like this. I'm also doubling the melody on the Xtar Lite, which is already a free instrument made from sort of like leftover scrap recordings from the Intimate Viola sessions. Sounds like this. And together with the Intimate Viola harmonics. As for percussion in the last section, same thing again, except you can see I duplicated the track and I changed all the sounds so that it would sound different from the first time around. So with that out of the way, let's hear the final section with everybody together. So that's how I did that. And yes, I do think that limiting your options makes you more creative. It certainly worked for me. If you're interested in learning more about the TriPack, there is a separate video, link below, where I show you every feature and sound that your $1 gets you. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next one. Bye bye.